that are overcoming your full adder. In half adder, we can go for a arithmetic addition of two single bit. Okay. Now here what we are doing, that let us assume that we are having A and B as the input. We are having A and B as the input. So for A, we are having A naught and A one. For B, we are having B naught and B one. This A naught and B naught are the input that we use in case of your half adder. Those are there. Okay.
And
here we are adding it with this C naught. C naught is, it is the carry of your A naught and B naught. So in half adder, whatever the carry we are having, so that carry is this one. Okay. And S naught, this is the sum that we are having in case of your half adder. Okay. So now what we are having? Now we are having A one, B one, and C naught. C naught is the previous carry of your A naught and B naught. So these three will become the input. And what about the output? At output, we will have S1. S1 is your sum. So it is sum of these three. And when we are going for summation of these three, there are chances that you may have a carry. So that carry you are having C1. So, in case of your full adder, you are having A1, B1 and C0 as input, and you are having S1 and C1 as output, where S1 is the sum and C1 is the new carry. Okay. And if you are going for making the truth table, you will have, this is the truth table. In this truth table, you are having A1, B1 and C0. So these three will become the input, and in the output you are having C1 and S1. C1 is for carry, this is the new carry, and S1 is your sum. Okay, and as here you are having three input, you are having A1, B1 and C0. So all these different combinations that are possible in case of here, the number of possible inputs that you are having is 2 to power 3, that is 8 different combinations are possible. So for these 8 different combinations, what is your sum output, what is your carry output, that now you have to